Like to invite our next speaker, Ms. Archana Garg. Archana Garg, founder and CEO of Power Talk with Archana, is the awardee of Women Entrepreneur of the Year 2020 by the Associate Chamber of Commerce and Industry of India and Women in Excellence, Indian Achievers Award 2020. A keynote speaker, global coach and mentor, and a specialist in public relations and communications. Now, I would like to invite Archana Garg, ma'am. Over to you, ma'am.
Thanks a lot for inviting me over, and thanks, Nishikant, for having me over. It's an absolute pleasure always to speak for ASSOCHAM. I completely echo the perspectives expressed by all my panelists, Vinayji, Jyoti, Malika, Ratinji, and Mansukh ji ke vichar sunke, unki journey sunke, really bahut zyada protsahan mila. And I wish hum unki puri baat sun paate, but I think it's a very, very good stage that you have created today, and thank you so much for this. Now, when we talk of startups, you know, I think if we can address that gap between the demand or supply, or meet the unfulfilled, unmet requirements of any business, or we can level up, you know, and create that idea where we can, you know, kind of develop it into a business, then I think we're already in that space, that ecosystem, provided we can turn it into our idea into a business, which is not only aspirational, but also sustainable. And we need to use the right ingredients to make it work for ourselves. So as I've also spoken about it in my last interaction at ASSOCHAM, that, you know, it is important for all of us to understand that a great idea can be executed well with the right strategy, with the right action plan, with the right policies, the right team for enable us to run our businesses for the longest time possible. You know, I feel, you know, COVID has definitely changed the entrepreneur's outlook, you know, on success completely. Now, digitalization definitely without a doubt has taken a forefront. Now, we have always been talking about artificial intelligence or machine learning, you know, but post COVID, you know, these things have been automatically literally been weaved into our lives, if I can say so. And, you know, talking of the small and medium scale businesses, I think they will continue to mushroom, because today we are talking about the trends that now, you know, startups will see, you know, the kind of trends our market will see as far as startups are concerned. So small and medium scale businesses will continue to mushroom, and the focus is going to be on solving operational challenges and developing trust among consumer and offer the convenience. So if we were to consider the kind of trends that we can expect in the industry, you know, going forward, I feel, you know, number one would be EdTech. Now by EdTech, I mean, now we already have a variety of MOOC available by the best of companies, and they may also be coming for free completely, you know, the online courses. But I think now with EdTech taking the forefront, these courses will be maybe more personalized, more individual based, you know, with a focus on self-paced learning. So professional education courses, you know, are driven by innovations, you know, making sure that the learning content is in requirement to meet the need of the consumer today in India or abroad. So, you know, I think it is very, you know, EdTech is definitely going to take the forefront as for, you know, the startups are concerned. And according to the report, you know, our education market today, the Indian education market is expected to grow two times. It is expected to grow two times. That means 225 billions by the year, financial year 2025. Now, education today is 117 billions, which is expected, as I said, two times, you know. Now, if you are talking about Byju's, if we know Byju's is Byju's and An Academy, these are two very big learning platforms, e-learning platforms, education e-learning platforms. They have, you know, raised a capital of almost $2.32 billion, you know, in 2020. So EdTech is definitely going to be an area which is going to take, you know, a good shape here as far as startups are concerned. Second, again, I feel FinTech, you know, because we've seen that in COVID times, you know, every small business has gone online because they wanted to sell their products or services. Now, to be able to accommodate that, I think fintech is going to come in a big way again. More and more software development companies are going to come forward to facilitate e-commerce operations. Now, in fact, there are studies, there is data available which says that there is a 40% increase post-COVID, COVID के जाने के रहते रहते हुए भी 40% increase हुआ है demand में for the web developers, the VR experts, the AI designers, and infrastructure architects, cyber security experts, and specialists and analysts, which means fintech is going to come in a big way. This is one area which again startups can explore. Again, third, we can consider health and wellness. Subscription-based programs, jo hai, wo I think is going to really take a leap again. They are going to be a part of our ecosystem because people have understood that health is wealth. So subscription-based programs, personalized programs, target-based programs are going to be there, for people to relish. Again, I feel fourth could be sustainability. I think this area ke andar, again, we will have a lot of startups jo ki, are going to surface, We will see many, many, many companies who are going to mushroom talking about sustainability, meeting UN sustainable goals. Like just Ratin ji khud karte hai, and they are into water recycling, we have renewable energy. So green businesses are in, green businesses are in, and there are going to be many, many companies who are going to be supporting bigger companies to achieve this. Maybe, renewable energy or water cycling. The target is going to be reduce and recycle and reuse. फिफ्थ आई थिंक फिफ्थ इंडस्ट्री जो मैं सोचती हूँ कि इस पोस्ट कोविड स्टेज के अंदर फोरफ्रंट में आने वाली है दैट इज फार्मा फार्मा इज रियली गोइंग टू टेक अगेन अ बिग टाइम लीप बिकॉज जेनेरिक मेडिसिन जो हैं उनकी प्रोडक्शन इंक्रीज होने वाली है सो वॉट विल हैपन इज दैट जेनेरिक मेडिसिन अगेन इट्स अ बिग मार्केट फॉर श्योर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड प्राइवेट लेबलिंग इन दिस सेक्टर शैल प्रिवेल कंपनीज अगेन They would want those generic medicines to be your private labeling is going to take again a a great charge here. Another thing in pharma, I think, or the pharmaceuticals or the medical side, the testing and standardization of medical devices. I think that is one another industry जहाँ पे पैसा लोग बहुत लगाना चाहेंगे and छोटी companies develop होंगी To make sure that we have good facilities which are driving testing and standardization of medical devices. Another very important point, I think, is number six that I would like to bring forward is cohorts of startups. Ye zarur hone wala hai. Small, all these small startups that we have, who share common markets, who share common interests, who share common expertise, or their expertise are complementing the existing ecosystem. They are going to collaborate and come forward as one big startup where they can, churn out the best of revenues together. I think that is really going to happen. Even if we see, if you have heard of an academy, if you've heard of Byju's, or if you've heard of Akash, Akash is a very big, education learning platform in the north of India. They have again collaborated with Byju's. Byju's is a Bangalore-based company. So this is going to happen. We will see lot many cohorts of these startups, many startups coming together and acting as one to generate more and more revenue and add value to the ecosystem. Another point which I would like to highlight, I think gig economy बहुत ज्यादा is going to come in the forefront because there are people available to work as freelancers. Now, why this economy is on the rise and startups उनको कैसे support करेंगे? Because the startup will not have money to hire people who of that level. So they will have these freelancers hired from time to time and use their services, use their expertise to develop a more innovative team, So I think gig economy is again going to come in a very big way, and there are going to be companies that are going to form a platform to offer these freelancers look for a job for them, and place them on different projects going around the startups. I think these are seven areas where I see that if we talk of the trends of 2021 or going forward post-COVID life, these are the areas where I feel the startups will start thriving. There is no dearth of investors that will happen provided we give them the right picture of how we are going to scale our businesses. I think this is the scenario of the startup going forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Archana, for your great insight. I guess this is the a much valuable insight in terms of the startups founders who are ideating a stage and planning to start something new, collaborating with each other, and also joining hands with the bigger companies actually. So
Thank you.
good.